There's been an explosion of tea places in the metro in recent years, but none of them can boast of putting tea in the food mix.
Well, Caroline Howard takes us to the Yude Tea Lounge in the Fort in Taguig for a taste of tea-infused cuisine.
From ritual tea ceremonies in China and Japan to afternoon tea in England, the aromatic tea is taken hot or cold anywhere else. Its herbal variations sought for their calming, if not medicinal, properties. It comes as no wonder then that next to water, tea is the most widely consumed beverage in the world. Given the popularity of teas, it's becoming more than just a trendy fix, with some choosing to start a new culture of tea consumption. Trained by some of the world's best tea blenders, Rene Sebastian, a certified tea master, explores the familiar world of teas in search of that perfect blend.
I just was really intrigued. In one of my trips, I saw that they were combining tea with other herbs and spices. I didn't really know that you can actually concoct something and mix things, and that got me inspired and I gave it a try. I actually formed Ayuda in New York City, in Manhattan, and I started at the organic markets on West 76th in Columbus. And at that time, I wasn't necessarily just thinking about tea. Dayuda is a total wellness company, and in my mind, I was thinking there are three divisions of wellness. There is your internal wellness, which is through teas, your external wellness through use of natural body care products, and an expression of your wellness, which is, I interpreted into fashion.
From the idea of ethnic-inspired clothing apparel from Philippine tribes, Rene has since spun off a modern take on food and teas.
Our mantra is traditional wellness for modern lifestyles, and that is really, I am inspired by our traditions as well as other ethnic traditions, and I want to bring it into the new. Whenever I mix tea, I always have to be inspired. I just give it my own spin, and I know that Filipinos are foodies. And I thought, well, what a brilliant way. If I could communicate in the language that they already know and introduce tea in it, inject it in it, perhaps maybe then it would open up their minds and also encourage them to explore tea more than just, say, pouring hot water over a few leaves.
Ayude serves up a new world experience via a menu that celebrates the world tea culture.
We carry many, many leaves that I've hand-picked myself or hand-blended myself. And as far as the food are concerned, also celebrating world cuisine, again, with the twist of tea infusion in them. Dayuda Tea Lounge, we make a constant effort to really play that balance. And we've done it in the drinks, from, you know, iced teas to hot teas to cocktails that are infused with tea. And also in the food, we handpick where and when we actually will introduce or inject the tea portion of it in a cuisine.
Just how are you pushing the possibilities of tea in the brew and in the stew?
One of our favorites here right now in the lounge is a true masala. It's a chai latte. I really do it the traditional Indian way. The best remark I've had was that it is the closest thing that they could get here in the Philippines to street side chai, which is really with cardamom and ginger and pepper, anise, cinnamon, all these lovely spices, and of course black tea. For food, I really do like the mushroom and mascarpone pasta. For the crisp pork banh mi, our best seller, is really great because it's a three-day curing process. We actually infuse the tea for 3 days and then get it to a crispiness that most people like really enjoy right now. And of course, there's the sriracha vegetable slaw with it, some cilantro for that Vietnamese feel. For the pasta, I really love also the roast vegetable arrabbiata. We've actually infused oil with tea.
Rene gives us a preview of one of Dayuda's tea-infused pasta dishes.
For our Dayuda's mushroom mascarpone, we use some garlic, salt and pepper,
three types of mushrooms. We have a button mushroom, shimeji, as well as shiitake mushrooms. Here we have our tea-infused oil, which we use, and it uses Dayude's lavender dala. It's kind of an Earl Grey with lavender. And of course, we have a little bit of cream, the mascarpone cheese, vegetable stock, a little bit of herbs, and finally we use casareche for our pasta. Okay, this is Say. He's going to be helping us make the mushroom and mascarpone pasta. We start off with sauteing some garlic with butter. Now we're going to bring in the mushrooms. So we saute the mushrooms up to a point where the moisture is coming out already. And then we get some vegetable stock, put some cream. It's my favorite, the mascarpone cheese. Once it's melted, we put in a pre-boiled casareche, a little bit of salt, and a little bit of pepper. And we put in some herbs, which is some basil and parsley. This is the tea-infused oil. We're gonna toss it now with the pasta. Okay, and to plate it, we just put a little bit of parmesan on top, some lemon zest.
Here we have the beautiful mascarpone pasta with a black tea and a hint of lavender, so I'm going for a bite. There's a nice balance between the mushroom and the black tea mixed with lavender oil, and really, there's a floral hint to it too. We also get a taste of another Dayude concoction. I'm going for something new now, the grilled corn and clam chowder with a black tea infusion, but right now, I'm going to have the chowder alone. But this is a world experience. This actually takes me back to San Francisco. But now I'm curious to try how this chowder tastes with a smoked black tea. You know, there's a smoke characteristic to this, quite akin to bacon. And there's no meat. With this aromatic cuisine, a sense of calm comes over you, bite after relaxing bite. That will do it for this edition of Taste Buds. I'm Caroline Howard. Remember, life's a treat. Till next time.